Hi, you guys. This is all twisted. Okay. So, do not mind my brows or my hair. I just dyed it yesterday and put it in a bun two nights. With that being said, please take every single prophecy to our Heavenly Father first to ensure that it is for you. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone who has subscribed. I love you guys so much. With that being said, let's get into this prophecy. My apologies. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get one out today. Today is Thursday that I'm filming. And I know I did put one out today. But yeah, we're going to pick up the speed on it. Okay, y'all. So let's get into it. In this dream, my cat innocently went into a chicken coop, not knowing it was going to be outnumbered and ambushed. So basically, when she went in, there were a ton of chickens around her, and she started trying to engage with them, and they, you know, jumped her. Okay, so let me get a scripture for this. Heavenly Father, please give me a scripture to go with this dream. The scripture opened up to Isaiah 10 and 14. As one reaches into a nest, so my hand reached for the wealth of the nations. As men gather abandoned eggs, so I gathered all the countries. Not one flapped a wing or opened its mouth to chirp. Does the axe raise itself above him who swings it? Or the saw boosts him against him who uses it, as if a rod were to wield him who lifts it up, or a club brandish him who is not wood. Therefore the Lord Almighty will send a wasting disease upon his 30 warriors. Under his pump a fire will be kindled like a blazing flame. The light of Israel will become a fire, their holy one a flame. In a single day, it will burn and consume his thorns and his briars. The splendor of his forests and fertile fields, it will be completely destroyed. As when a sick man wastes away, and the remaining trees of his forest will be so few that a child could write them down. That's deep, y'all. So in this scripture, I'm reading like, okay, in this Bible, it has the scripture and then it's like a definition. And I was just glimpsing over their definition or what they presume this scripture meant. I feel like with this scripture, God is saying that he is going to start reaching his hand into the nest of the nations for the wealth, okay? And he is going to pull down, but he already says this, in the end days, he's going to pull down the great nations, and he is going to bring up those that are down. In fact, the next part, in the day of the remnant of Israel, the survivors of the house of Jacob will no longer rely on him who struck them down, but will truly rely on the Lord, the Holy One of Israel. God wants his children to rely on him and not man. Because when you rely on man, you never know what ulterior motives are going on. You never know what someone really truly means for you. We are living in a world where I'm getting so emotional saying this, because I have had so many people come in and say that their own moms, you know, and I've seen that in my dream, your own, if we are living in a world where a daughter feels as though her mother is treating her a certain kind of way and turning on her and mistreating her. And, you know, I know it's not just my channel. I also have been very attentive to channels that speak about narcissistic parents and mothers. And we are living in a world where anybody can turn on you. And when things like this are going on, we have to rely on the word of God. We have to rely on hearing from God to know what it is that God wants us to do. Because if we don't, just like in my dream, how my cat wandered into a chicken coop, not knowing what was in there, not knowing what was going on, and just got ambushed. We can unknowingly walk into an ambush simply because we did not listen to God when God told us, no, don't go that way, go this way. No, don't do that, do this. And it is hard. It is a hard realization, y'all. It is hard when you are, basically feeling as though you're backed into a corner, and you feel as though, well, how am I going to get out of this? Well, what do I do now? And God is basically saying, rely on me, listen to me, do what I'm telling you to do. Don't listen to what everyone else is telling you to do, because you never know how everything will turn out. And as for me, I have heard the word of the voice of the Lord, and I listen. And, over these past, I would say 6 months, 7 months, this entire year, I have been solely relying on listening to God, because I have seen what happens when I don't. I have seen what happens when I decide to just do what I want to do, when I allow myself to take the drive seat, when I do what Star wants. When I do what Star wants, things just fall apart. Star will walk into all kind of traps. We've already went over how I have been through being set up and, poisoned, and just I've been through it, y'all. And I can say that I know things always turn out better when you listen to what God wants you to do instead of doing what you yourself want to do. You don't want to do that. You don't want to put yourself in a position to where you have to try to figure it out, or you now have to go to God after God told you not to go anyway, after God told you not to do it anyway, and now you have to go to Him and you have to ask Him, well, how do I get out of this? Okay, so I don't know who this message is for, but this is for someone who is on the brink of a decision, and the decision may seem very small to you right now, but God is saying this is a big decision, because God Himself is telling you not to do it, not to go. It's something that you are going to do. God is saying, don't do that. Do what I told you to do. And yeah, that's the message. Like, God is simply saying, if you do that, you are walking directly into some kind of plot, some kind of plan that your eyes cannot see, but God sees it. And God is trying to protect you from whatever kind of plot or plan is trying to be made against you, because we never know what the enemy is trying to plot on us, what the enemy is trying to plan on us. Sometimes our futures are great and we can't even see it, but the enemy does. And the enemy will deliberately put things in position to try to stop you from doing what God wants you to do, or to try to halt your destiny from happening. However, God will always be there for us, but we have to be on our, we have to be on our toes. We have to keep our eyes on the prize. God is like, be on your toes, keep your eyes on the prize. Don't allow anything on the outside to distract you from what is the focus, okay? So I don't know who this is for. I pray that it reaches you. And let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this dream. Thank you for this word. I'm not sure who it is for, but I pray that it reaches them, Lord. I pray that whatever trap lies ahead, that it will not come to pass because it is not their portion. I pray a victory over this person's life. And I pray that you will cast down your angels to assist them in whatever it is that they are doing. I pray that whatever plots and plans and evil wishes are coming against them, that they will fall at the enemy's foot. I pray with all my heart and soul. In Jesus' name, what I could is that Vina Ivonzi my shade a bit. So I caught up once in my a very guy von clean I moji. Zavi Taive Zik I von ye. Javini my Zamaikon. Koreka is a very my Zovonekai my G. Javirike. Jagai voice guy made a yang of one. And Zing I moji. Even I ye. Ok my G guy voye. Yeah. Okay. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Deuces.